Hi everybody. I just wanted to do a little quick market update about what's going on in the real estate market to give you an idea of everything that's happening right now. So the big story in the news lately is the Bank of Canada has been raising interest rates pretty aggressively. They just did their third increase of the year, and it again was another 0.5%, bringing it up to 1.5%, which is still quite low, but I think a lot of the issue right now is market sentiment on how high rates can go from here. The general expectation from economists that I've listened to is that they will probably go up to about 2.5% at some point before the end of the year and then hold rates at that level. The big story that you'll probably see in the news tomorrow is TREB just released their monthly data for the month of May. Is that sales are down 38.8%. One thing to take into consideration from this is we're coming off of a very high level in 2021 because there's a lot of pent-up demand from the beginning of the pandemic. So in 2021, we were at about 11,900 sales, and this month we're down to 7,283, which sounds like a big drop-off, but if you go back a bit further and you say, look at 2019, for example, we were at 9,980 sales, and then 8,402 sales in 2018. So yes, we're sort of lower than the historical norms, but we're not extremely low. So the next thing that I sort of looked at is I did an analysis on sort of how the market has fared over the last 4 months since February, which is sort of when the Bank of Canada started these interest rate increases. And in general, prices are down. The detached 416 market's down 7.6%. Semis are down about 4.8%. Row houses, freehold towns, and other attached homes are down 12.5%. Condo towns are down 4.87%, and condos are down 3.52%. Inventory is starting to climb up, and condos and detached are currently sitting over 2 months of inventory from about under 1 month of inventory back in February. So there is more people listing their homes and less buyers out there right now. The condo market itself has been pretty resilient. As you saw, prices have remained relatively flat, so we're not seeing a huge difference there. But there is definitely a big run-up in inventory recently, so I'm sure we're probably going to see some more pressure on pricing there over the next coming months. The rental market is very strong right now because a lot of people are putting their buying decisions on hold. They're looking at rentals, which are doing very well, and most rentals are getting multiple offers right now, and prices are getting pushed higher there. And the expectation is that will continue over the next year and a bit. When it comes to opportunities in the market right now, there's a lot of deals to be had. I just saw a detached house sold last night for just under $1 million, which easily would have gone over 1.3 at the beginning of the year. So if you're a buyer and you're sitting on a good down payment, there's definitely opportunities where you can take advantage of people that are looking to sell their places or have to sell right now. The real question is, how long is this all going to last? I don't think anyone really knows for certain, but the general expectation is that we'll probably see a downturn that will sort of come down a bit over the next coming months as the rates continue to go up. But then the expectation is the market should recover pretty quickly. The underlying fundamentals of the market are still very strong. We still aren't building enough homes for the demand that's out there. Immigration numbers are all very high, and in general, the market looks like it should sort of rebound relatively quickly. So that's all for now. If you have any questions about the market, you can always reach out to me anytime, and look forward to hearing from you. All right, have a great day. Bye-bye.